In today's episode on the Dive Saga channel, we are going for a freezing adventure on Lake Superior in Michigan to learn ice diving. Yep, that's me. So, how exactly did I get here? I started my travels in the Sunny Bay Islands of Honduras and flew into Detroit, Michigan for a 7-hour car ride north to the Upper Peninsula to the town of Munising, which gives us access to Lake Superior. I have certified thousands of divers and hundreds of instructors, but every year I try at least one scuba class for me that makes me feel what it's like to be in the student seat once again. This time, that is ice diving. That's Lake Superior out there. That's the largest lake of the Great Lakes, and I think it's the second largest lake in the world by surface area. You can't really see all of it because there's Grand Island right there kind of blocking it, but that's where I'm going to be starting my ice diver training tomorrow. It's important to engage in new scuba diving activities under the guidance of experienced professionals, so I team up with ice diving instructor Stephen Aynsley and the ice diving team of Divers Incorporated from Ann Arbor, Michigan to receive proper instruction.
So the dangers of ice diving are being lost underwater. Another potential danger is equipment failure due to the cold. And another danger we could face is getting too cold too quickly underwater. So what you learn during the ice diver course is how to mitigate against the three previous things we had mentioned. So we'll learn about the effects of cold and how to dress appropriately for ice diving. We'll learn a little bit about how gear works and why it would potentially fail and what to do in the event of that happening. We'll also learn a lot about site preparation so that we know how to set up an ice diving site safely. We'll learn how to tender ropes so that divers can maintain contact with the surface. And we'll learn how to aftercare those holes as well. So a lot of it is the technical side of site preparation and how to deal with the cold with regards to you personally and your equipment.
We pull our sleds onto Lake Superior and set up camp near the shore, in a spot where we know the ice is thick enough to support our weight. A person falling through the ice would be an absolute catastrophe and could very possibly result in death, so it's important to pick the location with care.
Our instructors have designated two dive sites where we're gonna be cutting the holes. Everything has been cleared of snow so that we have a place to work. And now they're gonna be cutting the holes with the coolest piece of dive equipment you have ever seen.
Once the location has been cleared of snow, the team cuts a triangular hole in the ice. The hole is triangle shaped, so there are three corners to sit in, one for the instructor and two for students. The cutaway block of ice is then carefully pushed underneath the ice sheet so that it can be replaced after diving. That way, we don't leave any dangerous holes for hikers or snowmobiles to fall into. Thank you. Not all forms of ice diving are overhead environment dives, but in this case, the only way in and out of the water is through the ice hole. That means that we have to anchor safety lines into the ice, and every diver will be hooked up to one of those lines with a maximum length of 30 meters, 100 feet.
The ice diving team doesn't just consist of the ice divers. They're actually teams of three: an ice diver, a tender, and a safety diver. The tender tends a 30 meter or 100 foot line that is attached to the ice diver. It is the tender's job to keep this line somewhat tight so that pulling signals can be perceived between the diver and the tender. At the same time, the line can't be so tight that the diver is restricted from moving. So giving some line and pulling some line back when needed is the job of the tender. The safety diver, on the other hand, sits somewhat ready to enter the water in case the diver stops signaling. That way, the safety diver can take a 60 meter line, so twice the length of the ice diver's line, enter the water and conduct a search pattern.
Besides getting lost or trapped underneath the ice, the other obvious danger to ice diving is severe hypothermia. The water today is minus 2 degrees Celsius or 28 degrees Fahrenheit, but the surface temperature is only minus 6 or minus 21 Fahrenheit. That means the time spent tending to the divers in the water holds just as much potential for undercooling as the time in the water. So proper exposure protection is absolutely indispensable. I am wearing my thick Scuba Pro K2 undergarments and a tri-laminate wetsuit with dry gloves. It is now my turn to dive. Although I have extensive experience in wreck diving and cavern diving, the idea of jumping into a small, dark hole in the ice sends chills down my spine. No pun intended. Regulator freezing is another very real risk while ice diving, so the trick is to keep the regulator dry and only start breathing when submerged. Once underwater, it is best to stay underwater because a wet regulator on the surface would freeze over immediately and cause a free flow. That is why we immediately push ourselves underneath the ice so we don't bob back up. Instructor Steven gives us a few moments to acclimate to this new environment. I expected a serious brain freeze in my 5mm hood, but to my surprise, I was fine.
More footage in a moment, but I want to stress that ice diving requires proper training and proper equipment. Ice diving is obviously very cold, but it can be safe and even pleasant if you use the correct equipment. That's why our next episode, we're going to discuss all the equipment used on these dives. So make sure to subscribe and hit the bell icon so that you get a notification when that episode goes live.
The view is mesmerizing. We are in a completely different world. The opaqueness of the ice is determined by the speed of freezing. Ice that freezes slowly is more transparent. The faster the ice froze, the milkier it looks. In some locations, the ice froze, thawed, and refroze in stages due to the water movement, and some interesting formations have formed. Absolutely inspiring. When we get closer to the hole again, instructor Steven gives us the sign to simulate an emergency. Continuous, rapid tugging on the line from our end sends a distress signal to the surface tenders. This is their cue to pull us in at a rate of 1 foot per second or 18 meters per minute. For safety reasons, this exercise is conducted in shallow water and close to the hole, so there is no risk of decompression issues. It's an important exercise for both divers and tenders to learn what to do in an acute emergency. A diver in serious danger can only be helped on the surface.
Whoa! Just got out of the hole. Nowhere near as cold as I thought it would be. My feet are a little frozen, but it was good. That was nice. That was really nice. My suit is immediately kind of frosting over, and I guess that's that's just what it is, because now we have to tend for the next team of ice divers, so we're kind of in charge of their safety. That's cool.
Over the course of this weekend, I've learned a great deal about ice diving and may even have found a new passion. Ice diving isn't for everyone, and it's really just a special skill to get to locations that are otherwise inaccessible.
If you listen, you will notice that my suit is entirely frozen. But we did it, ice diver certified.